Good afternoon. Welcome to another episode of Instagram Live. My name is Chris Sousa. I'm the fitness officer from King Campus. Today, we're going to be going over a couple different variations of the push-up. I know tons of people are probably really bored with this movement by now, being at home and training, but there's a lot of actual variations that you can do to make this a lot more challenging. And it really depends on where you're starting from. I'm going to go over first different regressions. So we're going to start with the easiest regression to the most difficult. So if you are at home and you're training or you're starting to train and you can't quite do a standard push-up off your toes, I'll walk you through what to do to work yourself up to that, okay? So the first variation is actually from your knees. This is a lot easier to do off your toes because a lot of your body weight is actually on your legs. You're not supporting it with your arms. So what you're going to do is put your knees down, and we're going to follow kind of the same rules as a regular push-up. Our hips are going to be straight. We have a nice straight line. We're going to push out against our abs. Bring our body all the way down. Our chest touches the floor. And then we're going to press back up again. So you can see my hands are just over my shoulders. They're not too wide. They're not too narrow. I'm allowing my elbows to flare back on an angle. I come down. Chest touches the floor. And then I press back up again, fully extending my arms. Okay. So that's the easiest variation. There's actually easier variation if you still can't do push-ups off your knees. You can do them against the wall. Okay, so you just get yourself up against the wall. The closer you are to the wall, the easier it is. Okay, so the further you are, the harder it is. What you're going to do, just pretend my hands are against the wall here. You're going to start off, lower your body towards the wall, and then press back out again. Same thing. Come about an inch away from your chest because you might not be able to get all the way down. Press back up, fully extend your arms so your elbows are locked out. And then come back down again. Okay, those are the two easiest variations. The next one we're going to do is a standard push-up. Now, a lot of people actually don't correctly perform a standard push-up, so it's a lot more difficult than it actually looks. So what we're going to do, I'm just going to make sure you can see me here. I'm going to fully extend my legs into a almost like a high plank position. So a lot of people, what they'll do is they'll start a push-up with their hips hanging down, and what they do is they'll come down, their hips touch, and they come back up. So you're actually cheating yourself a lot of range of motion there. And range of motion is just basically how far you can go down into the rep and how high you can come up. So if my hips aren't sagging down and they're nice and aligned, you can see it. There's a lot more range of motion. Chest touches the floor. And then I come back up again. Again, my hands should be below my elbows and my elbows should be below my shoulders. Okay. With that one, you want to make sure you're touching the ground. A lot of people don't do that either. They'll come down halfway and then come back up. So if you're doing the full range of motion, it's a lot more difficult. It's also a lot more difficult if you're keeping your body rigid and keeping that straight line. Like I said, it increases the range of motion. So instead of coming down to here, when my hips touch and prevent me from going any lower, I'm going to keep my hips straight, come all the way down, chest touches the floor, and then press back up again. Okay? So that standard push-up is a lot trickier than it actually looks if you're doing it correctly. The next one we're going to do is an explosive push-up. What we're going to do is get into that same position. So my wrists are below my elbows. Elbows are below my shoulders. I'm going to come down nice and slow. Chest touches the floor. And as I touch the floor, I'm going to explode up and then catch myself. Okay. So as you come up, your hands are going to leave the ground. Then you're going to catch yourself. Put your hands flat out. Absorb the shock of coming down again, and then slowly come down and press up again. Okay? So with that one, it's really important to hold your hands out. Make sure you're ready to catch yourself so you prevent yourself from coming all the way down. And you really want to slow down that range of motion. So that one is a lot more difficult because as you come down, it's almost like 4 or 5 times your body weight, if not more. So you have to make sure that you are proficient in a standard push-up before you get to that version. Another variation you can do is increasing the range of motion on a standard push-up. So this one I would do before the explosive push-ups. So you can just build up your base by using, I'm just using yoga blocks. You can use books, boxes, anything that's sturdy. You're going to go down, put them underneath your hands. I'm going to go this way so you guys can see. And this is increasing the range of motion. So you can see as I come down, I can go a bit lower. My chest isn't touching the floor. That usually prevents you from going any lower. But now my hands are all the way up. and press back up, okay? So you can see I can come all the way down between my hands instead of hitting the floor, and it increases the range of motion. And you can do the same thing. You can build that up so you can go a bit higher. It's another way of increasing it. And then the hardest one would be a clapping push-up. This one's really tough because you have to get high enough off the ground to be able to clap and then catch yourself again, okay? So make sure that you can do the standard push-up proficiently, the explosive push-up proficiently, before going on to a clapping push-up. It's a bit harder on the wrists, but you do want to make sure that you're doing those ones routinely before you move on to the clapping push-up. So what you're going to do is get into the same standard position as a regular push-up, off your toes. You're going to come down, clap, and then catch yourself nice and low. What you don't want to do is come down, bounce off, and then try it again. Start with just one rep. Don't go consecutive reps until you can kind of build to get there, okay? So those are a ton of different variations you can use. The explosive rep push-ups, the clapping, the explosive push-ups, work your way up to 3 to 5 of those, long breaks in between. Range of motion push-ups is good for hypertrophy, so if you want to increase that range of motion, you can build it up by putting blocks down, books, stuff like that. You can also add external load, so you can use a backpack. Just fill it full of water bottles or sand if you have it, or even dumbbells if you have those at home. Adding external load is obviously a good way to work on your strength. A final, I guess, variation would be playing around with your tempo. So tempo just means how fast you're going through the range of motion if you're throwing in some pauses. So what you can do to play around with your tempo is you can either do a slow eccentric, so you're coming down nice and slow, you can count to like 8 to 10 seconds, pause at the bottom, and then come back up. Or you can do a fast eccentric and a slow concentric, so I'm going slow for 10 seconds all the way up. Or you can throw in some pauses where you do a regular push-up, pause at the bottom, you can either leave your hands off the ground or they can stay on the ground, pause for a couple seconds, and then press back up, okay? Another good way to kind of add variety. On Monday, we spoke on our wellness post about using mechanical drop sets. So mechanical drop sets are just changing the variations of an exercise. You can go from easiest to hardest, hardest to easiest, but basically you're extending your set. And you would do this all in one set. So a mechanical drop set for push-ups is you could start with your hardest progression. So you can do like a explosive push-up, and then you can do a regular push-up, and then a modified push-up. And what you would do is go to failure or near failure for all of those. And you take a minimal rest in between sets. And you can do that for 3 to 4 rounds. Obviously, if it's your first time using that technique, I would just do one round or just play around with the different variations. But the goal is to kind of decrease your rest time in between. So that's a really good technique to use, for strength or hypertrophy. So try those out. These are all things you can do outside too. It's a beautiful day, so make sure you get outside. Don't need any equipment for any of this stuff. Push-ups are really good for your shoulders, triceps, a little bit of your back as well, obviously your core. So make sure you're implementing them in your program. We do a lot of different variations for boot camps. So if you're interested, check out all our group fitness schedule. It's on our website. Check it out. Most of our classes do incorporate push-ups and different variations. So definitely try out one of our classes. But until then, we will see you. I guess I'm off next week again, but check back in again tomorrow for our lives. And be well, be safe, and we'll see you later.